You know, I don't often do review videos for bases that I don't sell new. Part of it is these videos take more time than you think. First of all, to get a couple of minutes of my playing that doesn't just completely annoy me is often sometimes takes a couple of minutes. Sometimes it takes a lot longer than that. Then, of course, everything has to be edited and uploaded and whatever. And it's just kind of a whole endeavor. So I don't usually want to put that work into a base that I'm not like a brand that I'm not representing. And then also to put the effort into a brand that I can only sell one of and then it's gone, just sometimes it's not worth the effort. However, sometimes I just get something that's cool or that I feel like, man, this deserves a little more wider recognition because it's really unique or interesting or neat. And so I do it that way. And this is one of those cases. And this is, I'm assuming it's pronounced Devon. It's D-E-V-O-N, could be Devon, I guess. But we'll just say it's Devon. I first played his basses at a NAMM show, I think a couple of years ago. And remember the time thinking like, wow, these are really nice. And had this on trade. And it's a great sounding bass, great sounding four string, really beautiful. So I just thought I'd kind of go over with you just so you could kind of see it. And if you're, you know, in the market for a four string, this is one I would heartily recommend. So let's kind of talk through it. Although now that I'm looking at it, I'm seeing I need to adjust the pickups just a bit. Anyway, it's a 34 inch scale four string with a chambered body. So it weighs just under 9 pounds, 8 pounds, 11 ounces, like basically 8.5 pounds. It's a chambered ash body and has a book matched Buckeye burl top with this gorgeous burst finish. It's really, really lovely. A bird's eye maple fingerboard, ebony neck, bird's eye maple fingerboard, and then a maple neck that's got a little bit of flaming. I don't think it's supposed to be like a flame maple neck, but it's got some flaming to it. Matching headstock. The pickups are Bartolini 9J. It's got a Bartolini 18 volt preamp system in it. It has push-pull for active-passive. And then blend, and then mid, treble, and bass. The battery control cover is magnetic. which I love that. No tools required. One of the few things that I wish F-Base did that they don't do. This finish he calls a Tiger Eyes Burst. And black Hipshot hardware, which obviously they make just amazing hardware. And this really great clear pick guard. You kind of maybe can't see it very well, but there is a clear pick guard there as well. A great base. The neck has a rolled edge fingerboard, so it is so comfortable to play. Especially if you're the kind of person that tends to bring a thumb over or whatever. It feels lovely. It's a great base. Available at fretspot.com for a very reasonable price. I think I have this marked at like $3,000, $29.99. This is a heck of a base for that price. This base looks like there's also sort of a pseudo ramp between the pickups, which I'm just now noticing. I don't know what that's for. But yeah, stunning base. Comes with a gig bag, but this thing is in basically like new condition. And, you know, it's a tremendous instrument. So you're looking for a boutique four string. This is a great way to go. Head over to fretspot.com. If you see it on the site, it's available for sale. If you don't see it, that means someone else snapped it up and I can't get another one. So you're on your own there. But yeah, gosh, it's just a lovely instrument. So Devin Bass, check it out. See ya.